So if you're doing a website, and especially if you're doing it with a static site generator and you're using a CMS or not, and then you're thinking of what happens if my editor wants to see things, see changes before they are published, basically have a preview. So this preview topic is getting very important for people, especially for statically site generators.
Yeah.
And what is a preview, which is an important question? Basically, you want to preview your content and you want to be able to preview as many documents as you want, as many versions of your document as you want.
Let me explain this because it's very important, like mm-hmm. as many as you want. Like imagine, let's make a scenario. You are working on something, adding maybe new sections in the homepage, whereas I'm working on a new product page. There is a new product that I'm going to release. And I'm going to release it this month, whereas you're working on something for like in 6 months, something that you'll publish in 6 months. So we are both working on the same content, the same website. Okay, but I want to see what happens when my changes will be published. How will my product look like in the website before publishing it? However, I don't want the website to be broken by what you're doing, right? Yeah. You're changing the section, maybe you're breaking the homepage.
And if I'm working on a Christmas version, I don't want to see your changes because it has nothing to do with my work. So
right.
Yeah, definitely we want two different things.
Now we are, and now we are two. Now imagine the whole team, developers and content editors, trying to change things around. If you have a unique session, unique preview session, then it will break the collaboration. At some point, we'll have to call each other, I don't know, Slack each other to say like, hey, can I preview? Can you wait for me because I'm previewing? Can you stop using the preview maybe for a second? Can you remove your changes?
Yeah.
It becomes very
It's true,
broken.
And it's a concept that you can see everywhere. You can see it in the product with different version of a document, but you can see it, for instance, in GitHub, which is very common for developers, which is you create different branches which have like different version of your application and you don't have any conflict between them. It's two different versions on two different branches.
And that's what I like about it. Like we, as developers, it's normal for us. I need to do changes. I just do a branch and the branch is nothing. Just it's no investment. There's no server, nothing. Just create a new branch.
Yeah.
And it's conflict changes. Because you know that you are safe. When you create a branch, you know that you cannot impact other people. So it's kind of comfy. You know that you have your isolated environment.
And that's why in Prismic, we have things like releases, which are exactly branches.
Yeah.
You can work on your changes. I can work on my changes. And we will not impact each other. And especially, you can preview your changes without having mine. And that's very important, right?
Mm-hmm.
Now, the current approach of static site generators is to have some sort of preview server, right?
Yeah, and they have to create a preview server because the concept of a static site generator is to build your website, generate files, basically, that you can put on a storage or whatever, and you have all your website locally in files only. So you don't fetch any external data source. So
if like something like Gatsby we're talking about, right?
Yeah, Gatsby, Next.js, any static site generator. So if you want to create a preview, what you have to do basically is you build a whole new version of your website with new data coming from a release or whatever. So you have two different versions of your website and you need to serve it from your public version or from your preview server.
And for that, yeah, so you wanted to finish something.
Yeah, I wanted to say also, this is the example for one preview, but if you want 10 previews, it means that you need 10 different servers,
right?
Which is awful.
Right. And not a lot of CMSs have this kind of maybe concept of branches. And that's why maybe, you know, the static site generators are not thinking a lot about it. But it really breaks the collaboration not to have as many as you want of these sessions. And
I guess this concept, you don't really think about it right away. Because when you create your website, you're a developer, you will just publish your content,
probably.
Test it. But when the editor tried to create a new article and create new releases for Christmas or whatever, it becomes like necessary to have previews. And that's why it becomes necessary afterwards. And maybe other CMS didn't think about it at first.
And we chose to think about this completely differently for the preview. For instance, Gatsby, we did a plugin that completely acts differently. So this notions of a staging server or preview server, like gets me back to the years where we have to have different servers for things and all of that, environment, all of that. You don't need that. Our approach to this is much simpler.
Yeah, and for a good reason, because Gatsby brought something to the market is the fact that it's a React application that runs in the browser. So it's a very basic application that will just grab all its data from local files. This is the only difference with just a React application. So this is where we can really change things and say, okay, let's stop getting the data from local files and just fetch the data from Prismic, for instance, or from any API.
But some people might wonder, like, oh, running in the client when it is a preview session, does it mean it's slower, or what happens because it's not statically generated, right?
Yeah, because you need to make HTTP requests. But the only reason you do that is because you have this preview cookie. So you will just fetch the content from your API only if you are in preview mode. But once you deploy your website in production, you rebuild the whole website and you serve the local files, and that's it.
So it'll be back as a static website.
Standard static website.
Cool. Thank you, Arno.
Thank you, Sadek.